Hi, Lovazelle, and welcome back to my channel, and thank you so much for being here. Today is another much-requested video. If I could only pick one and have only one for the rest of my life, what would it be? So if you want to know more about it, hit the subscribe button, share this video with somebody you think might like it, and let's do it. Literally, I've probably gotten like 50 requests for this. So what the whole theme of this is if I was to never have makeup bought or sent to me again, if I was to only choose one item of makeup from each category, what would it be? And I have them all on my face right now. I just love the look that these products give me, honestly, and you can see why these are the ones I would just continue to use forever and ever and ever. If you want me to do a skincare version of it, please let me know and I'll make that for you guys. You ready? Okay. So let's get into primers. I do have two, the reason being is because they're different. So if I could only buy one primer for the rest of my life, it would be the, or illuminating primer, I guess I should say, would be the Milani Soft Focus Glow Complexion Enhancer. It gives the most radiant, gorgeous finish to your skin, right on top of, you know, your SPF, and then it just, for me, I have dry skin, right? And so for me, I just need that, you know, glow, that, you know, really lit from within look underneath my foundation. So this is my go-to one. My Charlotte Tilbury one used to be the go-to as well, but I just feel like you don't need to spend a ton of money on Charlotte, even though I love her line. This is just as good. And I'm in Nude Glow. Now, if I want just an overall, like, everyday run-around-the-mill, like, primer, it is going to be the Tatcha Silk, the Liquid Silk Canvas. This is what I actually have on today in the center of my face. I have this one on the perimeter of my face. It's a little extra today, but I just wanted to wear everything so you guys could see how it looks. And that is my Holy Grail primer. This is the second one I've got. I got this, I got one in PR, and then this is the one that I actually bought myself. Some of these products are going to be higher end, just because they're the ones that work for me. So hang with me here. All right. So then when we talk about foundation, this one is so hard for me because it changes all the time, no matter, you know, cause things come out. So of course, Kojin Doe has been one of my ultimate, the Aqua Foundation, ultimate Holy Grails. You know, Smith and Colt is one of my Holy Grails. Il Makiage is one of my Holy Grails. But these two, and I want to give you a drugstore version as well, but this one is the Anastasia brand new one. This is her, what is this called? Luminous Foundation. I have it on right now. It is fail-safe. It's something that I wear all the time. I love it. The skin looks amazing in it. And I still haven't bought a new bottle. That's how long this lasts. Then my drugstore version is the Milani Screen Queen. They are very, very similar, you guys. So if you're looking for a dupe, this might be one to try out. I also have Foundation Fridays on both of these, so you can check them out in my Foundation Friday playlist. Then we're going to talk about cream products, because I usually layer cream bronzer, blush, and then powder that over it because it has more staying power. So you've heard me talk about this a million times. This is the Butter Biscuit from Fenty Beauty. Again, I have it on. It is my Holy Grail, hands down, favorite bronzer I have ever owned, besides the Chanel Soleil, whatever, that I can't use anymore because they're not cruelty-free. But this is just as good. So, so fantastic. Now, the cream blushes, it's the same thing. It changes. Like the Jouer ones that just came out are gorgeous. I actually have a whole video that I'll link below, all of my favorite cream blushes. And, I mean, there's just so many. I mean, the Elf makes great ones. Daniel Sander. I mean, there's so many fantastic ones. Obviously, right now, my current ones that I have on is I have the pink one on from Jamie Makeup. She just launched her line. She is a friend of mine, and they're just something I've been wearing nonstop. So that's what I have on right now. And I love them. They'll last forever. Now, when we go into cream eye products. Again, you know, you've talked about, again, I have a whole video on my favorite cream eyeshadows. And there are so many different ones of so many different price points. Supergoop, Elf. I mean, there's so many great ones, but this is the ones that if I was to pick one that I had to use forever and ever and ever, it would be all of Charlotte Tilbury's cream potted eyeshadows. They're so gorgeous. Again, I have it on today. I wear them very, very often. It's just a quick swipe over the eyes and you're good to go. And that is what I do. I love, love, love them. Let's go into a blush and bronzer. Now, these are gonna be no shock to you, but literally they are the ones I've repurchased. They are the ones that are used the most. So for my blush today, I have on Charlotte Tilbury's. You can see how much it's used. her Cheek to Chic, right? Is that what they're called? Yep, Cheek to Chic. But this is an Ecstasy. It's the most universally flattering blush I've ever owned. I love it. I wear it all the time. Yes, Hourglass makes some beautiful blushes that I absolutely love. But this one for me is just, it goes right in my bag when I travel. For bronzer is going to be the Hourglass ones. I have been gravitating towards Diffused Bronze Light recently, but I pretty much have them all and I use them all just at different times. But again, that is what I have on today over that Butter Biscuit by Fenty. This is the one whenever you guys ask me what I have on my eyes and I'm just like, it's a bronzer. This is what I wear on my eyes tons and tons of times. So kind of a 2-for-1. And then this is also like, when you guys asked me to do this, it took me a little while because I'm like, I don't know if I can even try to do that. Like, I mean, there's so many products I love. Obviously, I'm a product junkie. But when we're talking about one palette, eyeshadow palette forever, for me, I'm not gonna really gravitate towards the ones with like a million different shades, just because I know if this is for me forever, I'm not gonna really be doing that. Like if I ever stepped away from being on camera and things like that, which I'm not, I would gravitate towards this beautiful palette from Charlotte Tilbury. This is in, it's called the Sophisticate, and it is all matte. It is what I have on my eyes today. I wear this religiously, especially just in my real life. This is what I travel with, and I can make a liner out of it. I can make anything. It's just such a beautiful, beautiful palette, and I love it, and that's the one I would use forever. So for powders, now this again is not gonna come as a shock. You can see how used up this is. I'm gonna actually show you, it's kind of like, I'm hit pan. Who hits pan on Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powders? I do. So this one is in Diffused Light. I usually use this underneath my eyes and down the center of my face. That's kind of where all of this kind of glow comes from. It's not highlighter. It is literally just that powder. And then for loose powder, which again, you know, I don't use a tremendous amount, but when I do use a foundation that's a little bit heavier or when I obviously want it to last a little bit longer, I go in with my Hourglass Mineral Veil. Am I obsessed with Hourglass? Have been, always will be. They make some of the best powder products. I do like Charlotte Tilbury's loose powder. It's fantastic. Of course, Cover FX makes a beautiful loose powder, but the reason why I like this is because it's not super matte. You know what I'm saying? Like a lot of the other powders are just like matte, 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 matte. And I don't necessarily want it to be matte. I want it to still glow, but I need it to set my makeup. This I will continue to repurchase. It's just so awesome. Now, when we talk about eyeliners, there are, and you guys know this, I don't really wear eyeliners a tremendous amount. I have it on today, obviously. So I'll let you guys kind of see just right here. This is a very typical like LI. This is the e.l.f. No Budge Retractable Liners. They are gorgeous. They are some of the best out on the market. This is one of my favorite colors, which is called Coffee. I don't usually go for a lot of deep eyeliners, except for brown, navy blue, purples, that kind of thing. I don't usually go for black. For me, on my skin tone, it's just a little too stark for me. But these, I have them in almost every color. Oh, Hunter Green in this is gorgeous. I mean, if you guys haven't tried these by e.l.f., you're sleeping on it. It is so beautiful. All right, so when we're talking about brows, this one's so fantastic. It's by NYX. It's called their Micro Brow Pencil. I absolutely love it. I use it in Ash, and it is something that I've repurchased time and time and time and time again. This is a perfect dupe for your Anastasia ones. It is so beautiful. All right, so to finish this off a little bit, the lips is gonna be a weird thing for me because I usually, on a daily basis, just wear chapstick, and that can be anything. My go-to one right now is the Tatcha Kisu Lip Mask. I've actually been wearing it for close to a year, but it's just like a chapstick, so for me, it's just kind of a whatever. But when we talk about lip liners, e.l.f. makes some of the best lip liners. They're so inexpensive. You can buy lip liners anywhere. So don't be so tied to a brand by that. It's more of the color. So I always go for a nude one, and yeah. But when we talk about lipstick, I am a nude girl. That's just who I am. I mean, every now and then I'll throw on something a little snappy, but this is what I love. So this what I have on is the Kim KW by Charlotte Tilbury, and then I have the ColourPop lip gloss I just talked about the other day over it. This is in Sun Soaked by ColourPop. This is pretty much what I do on a daily basis if I do wear lipstick, and I find it to be just my go-to color. Now, if you want to have one that's a little less expensive, this one by Bare Minerals, it's called Focus. It's just a touch deeper than Kim KW, but it's beautiful, and I've worn that quite often. And then the last thing I'll leave you with is liquid lips. Now, since a lot of us, whether you hate them or love them, a lot of us have to wear masks. And sometimes you want to wear lipstick under a mask, and this is going to get all over the place, okay? So my favorite liquid lips are actually by Beauty Bakery, and this is my favorite color. This is in Surreptitious. It's called their Lip Whips. They do not move. They do not transfer. They stay on the lips forever and ever and ever. Beauty Bakery makes some of the most beautiful liquid lips I've ever seen. So check them out if you're looking for a liquid lip to wear with, you know, out or with a mask, okay? So that is it. Did I forget concealer? I did forget concealer. I'm sorry. Let me go back. So Charlotte Tilbury's Magic Eye Wand is one of my favorite concealers, but I can live without it. I love it, but I can live without it because I have my Milani Conceal Imperfect. That's what I have on today. You've heard me talk about this forever and ever. I love this concealer. It is better than any higher price concealers that I've tried in a very long time. So again, another one. If you're sleeping on this concealer, get on that train. All right, you guys, that was such a fun video. I thank you so much for having such a fun time with me over the past several weeks. I mean, it's just been such a blessing to be able to create these videos for you and have some fun doing it. So to give back to you guys, I'm doing another giveaway, and it's going to be for one lucky winner, and it's going to win one of my goodie bags that I talk about, which is chock full of stuff. This is one of the ones that were, I have to fill it up a little bit more, but I have literally two more sitting over here. But win a goodie bag. Just in the comment section, tell me your Holy Grail product or just say hi. And the end date will be in the description box. And you guys can win a goodie bag for me. I just want to give back to you guys and tell you how much I love you and how thankful I am for you. And make sure you guys keep staying on here and all my social medias. I have some really exciting things coming up that I can't wait to share with you. All right, you guys, lots of love from me to you. I'll see you on the next one.